Welcome back to A Farmer Takes the Oregon Trail. We're at the Kansas River right now. We're about to go over some of the fundamentals of river crossing. Very important part of the game. If you mess this up, it can spell disaster for your entire run. So without further ado, let's get this party started. Okay, now we get to do the fun task of crossing the river, and we're going to be doing this several times throughout the journey. Rule of thumb with the river, it's pretty simple. As far as going off of this information, if it's about 2.5 or less, you want to go ahead and ford across the river. It usually works, but I'm going to go over all that here in a second. But I just wanted to make sure I threw this in here, because whenever you see it about 8.5 and you attempt to ford, you're going to fail. Pretty much all the time, and any method you use, with the exception of maybe one, you will have a chance of failing, but it kind of just depends on what the conditions are and how lucky you get as far as the random number generator, whatever they use in this game to do that. So let's go ahead and go over some of the options here. We'll check them out. Okay, now here are the options we got, and handy dandy, it shows you some information up top to kind of help you make a decision on what to do. But like I said, number one, you can attempt to ford the river. Pretty much you don't really do anything. You just take your ox and wagon and you just go ahead and go try to get across the river. But in this case, since we're at 8.5 feet, bad idea to do that, so I wouldn't recommend that. Caulk the wagon, that's pretty much where you put everything in, seal it up, and you float it across the river with the no ox to pull in the front, but it works most of the time. In this case, it usually does work. I think I've seen it fail only, I've played through the game at least three or four times, and usually it works. I think I only saw it fail once, so there is a chance it could. I'd say if it does, I'd probably just go back and reload and try again. But usually for the most part here, it'll work. And for other circumstances, it usually does. I don't know what the when not to do that, but it definitely works a lot better than fording. Option three, you can take a ferry. It's from what I've seen, it's usually 100% guaranteed you're going to get across, but the only problem is you've got to spend some money to get across the river. So in this case, since we're a farmer, we don't have a lot, so I could do that, but I'll just we'll go ahead and we'll take our chances and we'll go ahead and caulk the wagon. And then you can, if you want, you can wait and see if conditions improve. If the river depth gets a little lower, you can try to ford, but like I said, don't do it unless it's 2.5, which in this case, I don't think it's going to happen anytime soon. So I wouldn't even bother with that. And then 5, you can just pretty much, if you select option 5, it pretty much tells you what I'm telling you right here. So in this case, we're going to go ahead and caulk the wagon and see if we can get it float across. All right, beautiful. We made it across. No issues. All right, now let's go ahead and head to our next destination, see what kind of trouble we can get into on the way there. Okay, now what I'd like to do is, before we head to our next destination here, we're going to need to get some food because we didn't get that much back in Independence. So what I want to do here is I'd like to get, I don't know, maybe 600 pounds. But I want to wait till about March 20th. It'll help with the, as far as not dealing with the cold stuff. So if we can get some better weather going here. But yeah, like I said, this is my favorite part of the game right here. And I'll go ahead and I'll go over the fundamentals of that. So we'll go ahead and get that going. All right, hunting, my favorite part of the game. This is actually a pretty good way to get not only get free food, but if you also need to rest, if one of your party members is ill, you can go ahead and do some hunting. You might as well do it, because if you just rest and don't do anything, your party will get better, but or your health improves. But I like doing this because you get more food while you're resting, and you're killing pretty much two birds with one stone. From what I understand, as far as when you hunt, every hunting screen, it takes up a day, I believe. So if you get nothing, it goes by a day, and then if you get something, you know, it's kind of a luck of the draw on what you get here. But I really like how this part of the game was designed, at least in this version. From what I understand, I never played the really old, like 1972 version of this. Apparently, whenever you wanted to hunt, whenever the computer was doing its thing, you just typed in the word bang, and then it said, oh, you got some food, or you didn't get nothing, or I think that's how it worked. The only other version of this game I've played is, I think it was the Macintosh, I want to say it was the Macintosh version. It was pretty much the computer that came somewhat after this. It had the mouse. I remember it had like a shooting gallery type hunting sequence, but I remember it had big buttons you could push on the side of the screen, but I don't remember what computer it was. I want to say it was a Macintosh, but I can't remember. But I don't remember if it had a soundtrack, though, but I didn't really care much for that, because it was just too much like a shooting gallery, and I just wasn't feeling it. But anyways, I'm rambling, sorry. Get back to the subject at hand. This pops up basically every time you do a hunting sequence. It just tells you how to move. You push the I think it was called the return key back in the day, but now it's the enter key. But same thing. But that just moves your character. Arrow keys. You can point the rifle. If you'll notice, it says novice hunters and expert hunters. I'd usually prefer to use the novice because it just makes more sense to me. If you want a challenge, go ahead and use the expert keys. IOPK. Comma, all that good stuff, but it'll basically rotate your character so you can shoot at the animals. Then spacebar, you fire your gun, but that will also take away from all that ammo we bought at the store too. So that's why I bought a pretty decent amount, because we're going to do a pretty decent amount of hunting in this game. So yeah, we'll go ahead and we'll get this started. All right, here we are. Let's see what we can find here. Oh, there's a rabbit right there. Those guys, they're actually not worth killing because they don't give much meat. They're hard to hit, too, so you'd be wasting ammo. Oop, there's a buffalo right there. But you'd be wasting ammo if you try to get him, so I wouldn't recommend it. Ooh, deer. Look at him. All right, cool. They give decent meat. One thing to consider is when you shoot a buffalo, it'll actually give you 100 pounds, it'll give you 1,000 pounds, around 1,000 pounds, 63. Okay, that's pretty good. They'll give you 1,000 pounds, but you only take back 100 pounds. I guess your useless party members don't want to come hunting with you, so you gotta do it yourself. But if you shoot one, I might get this guy here. Let me see. I'm wasting bullets. Now here we go. All right. Bam. Okay, we're good. We don't need to worry about it. Once you get a buffalo. One thing to consider when you're playing this game is that the terrain. What interesting thing is the terrain actually changes as you progress in the game. There's a squirrel right there. As you progress in the game. The terrain will change, and also the animals will change as well, but they're usually just reskins. So there's usually like a really, what's weird about this game is the slower animals usually give you the best amount of meat, and the fast ones don't give you nothing. You figure, I guess they wanted to keep it realistic. That's fine. I mean, you're not going to see a buffalo zipping across the screen like the rabbits are, so. But, yeah, like I said, I like this is my favorite part of the game, and that's why the farmer, it's an upside to playing the farmer. You got to do a lot of, you have to do a lot of hunting, because you don't get a lot of money in this game with the farmer, so it's good stuff. As far as that's pretty much it. Just like I said, I usually try to find a nice wide open space that doesn't have terrain in the way. There's from what I can tell, there's no really way to tell when they're gonna pop in. They can just kind of come in through the corners and then kind of just take off. Okay, that one was a good one. So we'll get way too much, but that's fine. If you just kill one buffalo, you're good. You don't need to worry about killing nothing else, because all you can take back is 100 pounds, and they usually give you, for whatever reason, 1,000 pounds. I think it would have been a cool feature if you could bring your party with you, and they'd help you carry some of that back. But I guess it was a balancing thing or a software limitation. But, yeah, anyways, this is what I'm going to do until it's March 20th. Like I said, I want to hopefully get maybe at least 600 pounds in my inventory. We'll see how that goes. Just kind of depends on luck of the draw here. Sometimes you get something, sometimes you don't. So just stay vigilant. See, I wasn't able to get nothing on that round. So once I hit to that point, I'll maybe I'll show off this footage. Maybe I won't. But once I get to that point, I'll we'll continue on with the game and get on with getting to that Oregon Trail done, or get this game done. Yeah, I'm gonna be honest with you. This is my very first YouTube commentary video. Usually, most of my videos are centered around classic games like arcades and old console games. So if I sound a bit off or awkward or whatever, it's the reason why. It's my first time. Maybe I'll do this more. Maybe I won't. We'll see. I'm kind of wanting to do some role-playing games as well. I just picked this game because this game takes me back. I remember playing. God, what did I think it was like in elementary school. We used to have a computer lab, and I remember they introduced this game to us. And I think there was, what was the other one? There was one about Lewis and Clark, I remember, where you played as a tile with shoe prints on it or something. You had to go explore the Louisiana Purchase and head to the West Coast or something like that. And I remember there was a Dr. Livingston game in Africa. I never got into that one, but I liked the Lewis and Clark one. And then I remember a bunch of like Number Munchers, Odell Lake. I remember playing that. No, those are good classics on the Apple II that I enjoyed in school. But I remember whenever I was in the computer lab, I always had to put in a round of this game to see if I could just try one of the classes out, like the farmer or the carpenter, and do that. If I was just feeling casual, I'd put in the banker and just kind of play this game. It's a really awesome game, and I highly recommend tracking down some form, shape, or form. I haven't played all the versions of it, so I don't know which ones are good or bad. I know this one's good, and like I said, the Macintosh one wasn't bad. I just prefer this one over that one because I probably played it more than that one. But I know some had like the soundtrack on them too. That's pretty cool. Like a real CD. Like I think of back when the CD-ROM technology was getting better. But yeah, like I said, I think the game is still going to this day. I think I saw a Nintendo DS version, and I see there's a zombie version on Steam. It's called the Oregon Trail. I never tried that yet, but maybe. Maybe I'll do a video on that one of these days. But yeah, that's pretty much my history with this game. Like I said, it was this game, and I remember playing Number Munchers and Word Munchers and a lot of math games. That's how I got. It's actually how I got good at reading and math. Playing this stuff. Let's see. Am I ready? Yeah, we'll keep going here. But yeah, like I said, I was thinking about cutting all this out, but. Like I said, this is just maybe to show you how this works. Like I said, just that's all you gotta do. Just sit here and hopefully get a buffalo. And if you get a deer, I'd usually recommend maybe trying to get the rabbits or squirrels, but it's not a big deal. I'm trying to think of something else to talk about here. It's not coming to me. Now, let's see what we got here. 100 pounds. Okay. Yeah, we'll do another round. Has lost its perfume. I'll love you. Really? This happens sometimes. So don't get discouraged if you don't find anything for a few turns. Like I said, it's just kind of luck of the draw. Sometimes someone will show, okay, there we go, I got something. Give me some pathetic meat, maybe you can ask me for a day. Like I said, yeah, I'll go ahead and check right now. Let's see what we got here. Okay, got more than I figured. 663. All right, that's good. See, as you can see, I don't have much money, so I could have probably forded that ferry back in the river. No big zippity doo dah. Let's go ahead and let's see. Do I want to keep going? Yeah, I think we'll keep going here. All right. Well, we'll head to our next destination, and I'll see you then.